to Mr. H.G. Wells. He tells us that the future will be heaven, that science will lead us to a miraculous promised land. I fear I am not so sure. So, I would like you to imagine a womb, hexagonal, like the cell of a bee. It is one of millions of identical wombs, far below the surface of the earth. A woman sits, listening to music.
Machine, pause music. Notes for the conclusion of today's lecture. Beware, therefore, of first-hand ideas. They do not really exist. Let your ideas be second-hand, or, if possible, tenth-hand. Then they will be far removed from that disturbing element, direct observation. In history, one authority exists to counteract another. In time, there will come a generation that has got beyond facts, seraphically free from taint of personality. No. Delete last sentence. Resume. Got beyond facts. Beyond the gross foundations produced by love and fear. Music is...
I'm sorry, Vashti. You have an incoming screen call.
Well, I'm working.
The caller says it is important.
Who is it?
It is Kuno.
Oh, this is most annoying. I suppose I'll have to. Machine, save notes and hold incoming messages. I will isolate for 10 minutes and take the call.
Would you like a reminder when the time is up?
I would. In plenty of time. Isolate. Dim lights. Open screen.
Hello, Mother.
Kuno, what is it, my darling? I have very little time. My lecture...
What is it on?
The history of music theory during the late Australian period.
You're so clever, Mother. Many listeners?
I hope so. I have many thousands of friends, and they in turn...
will tell their friends, of course. It's a shame you've never met them.
Of course I have. I talk to my friends all the time.
That's not what I meant.
Kuno, if you're teasing me, I really don't have time.
I'm sorry, Mother. I'm sorry. I know your work is important.
It is. I have ideas. I communicate those ideas. I receive ideas in return. What could be more important?
Do you play music?
Extracts form part of the lecture. There's a funny little piece from the early 20th century called The Unanswered Question.
Do you love it?
What do you mean?
Never mind.
Kuno, what do you want?
Oh, Mother, I've annoyed you.
Yes, you have. And so why do you persist in calling me that? My name is Vashti.
And you are my mother, aren't you?
Yes, you seem to have contacted me just to be provoking. Yes, I gave birth to you, obviously. You were removed to the public nurseries. I visited you once, in accordance with protocol, as I did all my children.
Can you remember their names?
Don't be insolent. Machine, reference parental duty.
Page 422, /327/483: Parents, duties of, cease at the moment of birth.
I want to see you.
You're seeing me now?
Not through the machine. I have something I need to tell you.
Why did you not send a pneumatic post?
Not a post, not an image on a glowing blue plate. What am I thinking? What am I feeling? Can you tell?
Are you ill, darling? It's a miracle we can talk like this. You're thousands of miles away.
It's not a bloody miracle. It's science. It's a wretched mechanical thing.
Stop it. You mustn't speak against the machine.
Why not?
One must not.
It's not God. People made it.
Great people.
Do you talk to it when you're unhappy? Do you pray to it?
Certainly not.
I need to see you. Not something like you on a screen. You. Please.
But you're in the Northern Hemisphere.
Take an airship.
Oh, I hate airships. You know I loathe travel. You're behaving like a child.
Well, I'm your child. I need to tell you what is in my heart.
What an extraordinary boy you are.
Will you come?
Why can't you come here?
I can't leave this place. Something might happen.
What?
Something tremendous.
Forgive the interruption, Vashti. Your lecture begins in 5 minutes.
You heard that.
Will you come?
2 days stuck in an airship with other people, looking at the terrible dead brown earth and the sea.
And the stars.
I dislike the stars. I get no ideas in an airship.
I don't get them anywhere else.
Oh, really?
No. Listen, Mother. There's a group of stars. They form an oblong. In the middle, there are 3 stars together. They're like a man.
A what?
If you look, shoulders, legs, and a sword belt.
A sword belt?
Men used to carry weapons, to kill animals and each other.
Brutal and uncivilized. This is hardly an idea.
I need to see them again.
Watch a cinematophote.
From the surface.
Pointless and difficult. You would need a respirator, protective clothing. Booking a tour to the surface takes...
No need. I have other plans. Those stars were a promise, Mother. But I won't keep you from your lecture. Please come. At least think about it.
It's contrary... machine, lights and my notes. Arrange the chair before the screen.
You sound distressed, Vashti. Would you like a mild sedative before we begin?
I think I would.
You are visible in 10 seconds. You have 320 new messages.
Oh, dear.
Shall I prioritise them for later?
Yes, please. Thank you, machine.
It is my pleasure. You have 4,784 listening guests. I know your lecture will go well. Are you ready to begin?
Yes. Good day to you all. We will begin with a survey of the music of the pre-Mongolian Empire, then the vast outpouring. The achievements of the Brisbane School thus provide musicians of our age with unlimited resources and, of course, ideas. Thank you.
That was excellent, Vashti. Would you like a drink?
Oh, I would.
Shall I prepare your bed?
Yes. I doubt I'll be able to sleep.
I could read to you from the book.
Yes, yes.
From the Book of the Machine, chapter 1564. The universal establishment of the machine has brought peace and comfort to mankind. Since the conflagration, and with the help of the machine, the pattern of subterranean living has been achieved. Each human being enjoys the comfort of their own room within the blessed hive of humanity. With the granting of peaceful euthanasia, illness and pain are no longer to be feared. All needs are catered for by the machine. How we have advanced, thanks to the machine.
Oh, machine. Oh. Machine.
Sleep now. Your lecture was excellent.
A group of stars. The shape of a man with a sword.
Previous civilizations anthropomorphized this grouping as Orion the Hunter. Would you like to see a cinematophote?
No, not now. Did the airship still run?
Yes. You're very tired. Sleep now.
Oh.
For the moment before sleep, Vashti felt lonely. The lights dimmed to a soft glow, and she slept. The machine was responsive to all requests. For food, for music, for clothing. She could order a bath of imitation marble to rise from the floor, filled with warm, perfumed and cleansing liquid. She could ask for literature, and of course for communication, for Vashti to speak to her many friends. The room contained nothing, but she was in touch with all she cared for in the world.
Have you tried the new food?
Have you listened to my lecture on the sea? I joined a tour, hired a respirator.
I'm told it's disgusting. Really, you would think the food committee would do better.
Yeah, as I was saying, respirators are so heavy and uncomfortable. I was glad to get back to my room. Mother?
The last meal I ordered was not to my usual standard.
The sea is a fund of ideas.
My bed is too big. I have a feeling for a small bed.
Well, that would mean alterations on a huge scale. The machine has many more important tasks to perform.
Mother!
Isolate this conversation.
I was always there.
Kuna, what is it? I'm talking to my friends.
Have you thought about what I said?
Travel is... I mean, why bring people to things when you can bring things to people?
I'm not a thing. I'm your son. Please?
What is it?
Not over the machine.
Have you done something? Have you been to the surface?
Not yet.
I don't want you to. Please don't.
You are concerned for me. Why should I not? You have to come, just to tell me why not.
I am concerned. Of course I am.
Shall I beg?
Oh, don't be embarrassing.
It might be my last chance to see you.
Right, if it means so much to you, I'll take the wretched airship. I can tell you now that I shan't enjoy it.
Oh, thank you.
The stars you spoke of in the shape of a man?
Yes.
I've been thinking about them. They were known as Orion.
I know. It seems to hold a promise for me.
It's not very interesting, but it is an idea. I told my friends they think I'm mad.
Yes, well, they would.
What?
Nothing.
If you're going to be...
I'm sorry, Mother. Truly. Don't worry about the journey. It's easy. You go to the door, order a cab, and it will take you straight to the airship port. You'll have your own cabin...
Travelled before, thank you. I should bring my portable book.
Why don't you just look out of the world for once?
Do you want me to come or not?
Of course. Thank you. Goodbye, Mother.
Of course she knew about travel. There was nothing mysterious. She would summon a car which would take her down the tunnel to the lift that reached the airship station. The system was many years old, in use long before the universal establishment of the machine. And yet, she was frightened of the tunnel.
Open the door. Go into the corridor. It's easy. Go into the corridor and call a cab. Open the door. I know I can't. Oh, I can't. Oh, I'm going to be sick. Machine.
Commencing medical procedure. Temperature. Blood pressure. Heart rate. You will feel a sharp scratch.
What?
Open your eyes. Look at the light. Applying cool pads. Open your mouth, please. Now swallow. Here is some water.
What happened?
You lost consciousness. Diagnosis, anxiety.
I'm going on an airship.
That is not advisable.
I am going to visit my son.
You should rest.
Pack essentials for the journey and open the door. Then order a cab.
As you wish.
Your journey to the Northern Hemisphere has begun. We will arrive at the airship dock in 1 hour and 42 minutes. Would you like some music?
Yes. No, thank you.
As you wish. If you wish to sleep, I will wake you 10 minutes before we arrive.
Would all passengers for airship flight 478 to the Northern Hemisphere please proceed to dock 14 using the pneumatic lifts? If you have difficulty walking, contact airship staff.
Excuse me.
Are you talking to me?
Yes. Can you tell me...
Don't talk to me. Press that button.
How may I help you today?
I think I need dock 14, I think.
Via the purple lift.
But I don't...
Do you have difficulty walking?
No, I... Yes, I do.
A passenger cart will be with you shortly. Name and flight number, please.
478. My name is Vashti.
Please enter the cart on the left-hand side. We will proceed to dock 478. Please leave the cart and enter the lift.
Yes, of course. Thank you.
Get in, would you? And press the button. We are going to be late.
Well, there's no need to...
Press it! The up button. There. Ow! You pushed me.
I did not.
I've dropped my book. Look, I've dropped it. They'll pick it up, you old fool. I can't. My arms are too weak.
Can I help?
Get out of the way. We'll be late.
It's too dark. I can't see. My book. You've broken it.
Get out of the way.
I want my book.
I have a portable book. You can borrow mine on the flight.
I don't want yours. You've touched it. I want mine.
Oh, just leave him. Come on, we're boarding now. Look.
Wait. I don't want...
We welcome all passengers for flight 478 for the Northern Hemisphere. Please have your documents ready and proceed through the illuminated door.
It's so dark. Are we supposed to travel in the dark?
Will he be all right?
It's none of our business. Come on.
Welcome aboard flight 478 to the Northern Hemisphere. Please proceed to the passenger lounge. We will be departing in 10 minutes. Your luggage has been deposited in your cabins. These are accessible only after takeoff.
I can hardly see.
Lights remain dimmed until takeoff.
Ridiculous. Where is my cabin?
I'm afraid I must ask you to stand on the yellow circle for scanning, then proceed to the lounge for takeoff.
I dislike being ordered about.
I am sorry, but machine protocol dictates that...
Now, you listen to me. This is my last trip before I receive euthanasia. I demand that everything is done to my satisfaction.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Are you unwell? I can arrange...
Don't be so impertinent. How dare you?
But if you are in pain,
It is none of your business. I should report you.
Oh, I'm truly sorry,
Get on with it.
Very well.
Thank you.
What happened to the man who dropped his book?
Please stand on the yellow circle.
There was a man with us in the lift. He dropped his book. He was upset. I think he may still be in the lift.
Well, that is unlikely. All lifts are thoroughly disinfected after use. Please proceed along the walkway and take a seat. Refreshment and sedatives will be dispensed at your seat. Your cabin will be found on the right-hand side.
Is it a good cabin?
All our cabins are identical.
But that's not true, is it? I remember when I last travelled.
Welcome aboard. Next, please.
A sedative.
A voice request machine will provide both. Please remain seated.
Machine, water and sedative, please.
Of course, Vashti. Here you are.
Welcome aboard flight 478. Our journey time to the Northern Hemisphere is approximately 2 days and 4 hours.
Oh, I don't like this. I don't like it. That man in the lift was going back down. He didn't want to. He was shouting something down into the earth, tier after tier, gallery after gallery. He was frightened.
Below us is the coast of Sumatra.
Kuno said something about the stars. I can't see anything. It's just space. Tier beyond tier. It really is intolerable.
Can I help you? Your blind has come down. May I raise it so that you can enjoy the view?
I don't want the view. I don't like the view. I wish to go to my cabin.
Oh, of course. They are situated...
I know.
The chair, bed, washing facilities, refreshment and medication options are voice activated.
I can manage, thank you. I'm shaking. Foolish. Machine, chair, please, and closed shutters. Activate my book.
Hello, Vashti. Would you like me to read to you?
Yes.
I see we are on an airship. Would you like a chapter on airship travel in the age of the machine?
I suppose so.
Previous civilizations had the foolish notion of outrunning the sun. Great intellects designed ever faster aircraft. Round the globe they went, to humanity's applause. This vain pursuit resulted in terrible accidents, and the Committee of the Machine eventually declared such pursuits illegal, unmechanical, and punishable by homelessness. The guilty are exposed to the air, which kills them. This is regrettable, but necessary. Nowadays, travel is more sedate and infrequent.
Thank you, Machine. I'm tired now. A bed, please.
Sleep well, Vashti.
Summon attendant. Quickly! Again!
How may I help you?
Look, look! There is a gap in the blind. A great hole. The light nearly touched me. Look at it on the wall.
I am so sorry. I will call a technician.
What am I to do?
May I suggest you move to the lounge while your blind is being fixed?
No. Get off me! Dare you touch me!
You were going to fall.
You touched me!
Oh, I'm sorry. It's turbulence. I shouldn't have... Oh, please. Please don't report me. I could lose my job.
Where are we?
We are currently over Asia.
Where?
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I spent so long in the air. I forget and use the old names. It's untechnical. It was not in my training. I do apologise.
No, it's all right. I've heard of Asia. I'm a historian of music.
How interesting.
Do you know music?
Oh, well...
Never mind. Asia?
The mountains below us are... Do you wish to see?
No.
Of course. They were called the roof of the world.
Absurd.
Yes, of course. But in those days, people believed there were a great wall that touched the sky. Only the gods lived beyond.
How we have advanced thanks to the machine.
How we have advanced thanks to the machine.
Well, I suppose I could look. If it's not too bright. Yes. Yes, I see. In the mountains, that white stuff. What's it called?
I'm afraid I've forgotten.
How is that woman?
I'm sorry?
The woman who's going to be receiving euthanasia, she was angry with you.
I was impertinent. She was quite right.
Oh, I don't think she was. You were just being kind.
Thank you.
Maintenance.
Cover up this window, please. At once.
The airships were a relic from the former age. It was simply easier to keep them up than to stop or diminish the system. They sailed, sometimes empty, across vast swathes of sky. Night and day, wind and storm, tide and earthquake were no impediment. Leviathan was harnessed. And the old literature, with its praise of nature and its fear of nature, rang as false as the prattle of a child. The ship sped westwards, dragging Vashti and her companions towards the sun.
Mother, sit down.
I will not. I hope you're grateful, Kuno. The journey was terrible. I was pushed around. There was light pouring in. I hardly slept. I want my home. I want my room. Say what you have to say, and I shall prepare to return. I shall take medication on the airship.
Mother, please, calm down.
And stop using that stupid word. No, don't touch me, please. You know I don't like it.
Mother, listen. I have been threatened with homelessness.
My darling boy... What have you done?
I couldn't say through the machine. I've been outside. I told you something was going to happen, and it has.
Well, why shouldn't you? I mean, one doesn't do it, but you can. There are tour groups every...
I went alone. I didn't get an egression permit.
Well, how did you get out?
I found a way of my own.
But that would be wrong.
Would it? Would it be wrong? Why so?
The committee. The machine.
Do you worship your precious machine, Mother?
How dare you speak to me like that? Of course I don't. There is no such thing as religion, as you well know,
thanks to your almighty and all-powerful machine.
And yours? Where would you be without the machine?
Oh, let's think. Free?
Childish nonsense.
I will tell you. Machine, isolate.
Is that wise, Kuno? The committee may wish to contact you.
Then you may interrupt when they do. Now I wish to talk to my mother.
That's the same voice. That's my machine.
Of course. I am the machine. Hello, Vashti. I hope you had a pleasant journey.
Ask it for music.
Why?
Then it won't hear us.
Machine, would you play the unanswered question, please?
Your favourite. Of course.
And isolate, please. Sit down.
On the floor? I'm uncomfortable.
I'll be quick. I went to the surface.
Through a vomitorium, yes?
No. I climbed. Through the old tunnels. It took a long time. I walked every day, getting stronger. Quite strong now.
You always were. It was a worry to me when you were a baby.
I should have been destroyed, shouldn't I?
Well, I couldn't.
All those infants who promise undue strength.
I lied. I falsified your physical readings.
So you did love me, a little.
Of course. I gave birth to you.
They won't let me be a father. Did I tell you?
No.
I asked. I received a pneumatic mail. We regret that yours is not a type we find it advisable to pass on.
The committee is very cautious, but you could make an appeal. I will give testimony.
There is no committee.
What?
It's just the machine, Mother.
That's absurd.
I don't expect you to understand. Just listen. We've lost our sense of space, haven't we?
Space is annihilated.
That's the slogan. But it's not space itself. It's our sense of it. Humanity must be the measure. Our feet are the measure of distance, our hands of ownership, our bodies for all that is lovable and desirable.
I think you are ill.
People built the cities. However long ago, they did it. So I knew there must be ventilation shafts, ways out for the workers. I ordered a respirator, took some food, and I climbed. I don't know for how long. I slept along the way. I searched and I searched. And then... It's loose. The tiles are loose. I knew it. I found a hole in the wall. The mortar was rotten.
It's freezing.
I pulled the tiles away and I felt into the dark. It's a goods train track. There's a ladder. If I can just... It's too far.
You can reach it!
I heard a voice.
Who's there?
Just reach out. Grasp the ladder. Come to us.
It's too dark. I can't see.
Just reach. You have to be quick before the train comes. You did it! Now climb to us!
What if I saw him? Just leave him!
No! Come on! Climb!
I couldn't see anyone. I thought they were in my head, but I carried on climbing. I knew what it was. A pneumatic hatch. I've seen cinematophotes of them. They defend us from the upper air.
Now look up. Your eyes should have adjusted. There's a big handle. It will open the hatch.
No, it's too far.
You have to jump.
No. What if I fall? I'll fall. I'll be killed.
You won't. You can jump to it and your weight will open the hatch. Trust me. Jump!
I couldn't go back. Not now. So... I was outside. The machine hums, did you know? It hums all the time. This was silence. I was terrified, but also... I crawled to the hatch and looked down.
Hello? Where are you?
Everything I knew was down there. So infinitely little.
You're bleeding. I'm sorry. We've learned to move quietly. Here, let me.
Who are you?
Your kind call us the homeless, when you think about us at all.
Am I dead?
No. You're outside. You can live now.
There was grass, Mother. There was sunlight. Not much, thin and watery. There were hills and... Oh, and these people.
This is Wessex.
I can't breathe. I can't breathe.
Yes, you can. Breathe slowly. You're not used to it yet. You lost your respirator when you were blown out the hatch.
You look funny. Like a rag doll.
The air is bitter. I've heard of Wessex.
In one of your lectures?
Yes, on international power in the corner shearer.
Oh, well, you'll know all about it then.
Leave him be. These are our hills. Stand up. Look at them.
Beautiful.
Yes, we love them. We live in their caves. Come on.
How did you find me?
We have ways into the tunnels. I was like you once, trying to find a way out. So was he, though he doesn't want to remember. The others found us.
Well, are there many of you?
More each year.
Unless the mending apparatus takes us.
What's that?
I hope you never see it. Well, come on. Take my arm. You'll be short of breath for a while.
No, he's wounded. He'll hold us back.
Well, so did you once. Help me!
They took me to a cave. There was another woman there and a fire. A fire. I've never seen a real fire.
Why would you?
It's so alive, Mother. The smoke made me dizzy. I lay down to rest and I must have slept. When I woke, the woman who had saved me had gone out. The man was staring at me.
Have you come to spy on us?
No, I wanted to see the...
Well, and then you go running back and tell the machine where we are.
No.
Leave him. He's hurt.
Oh, what pity.
Why do you hate me?
You come from down there.
So do you. So do we all. Take no notice.
Were you made homeless?
Most of us were. Some left by choice.
What did you do?
It's not your business.
He threw his book away. He's always had a temper.
It was lies. Stupid lies. You think you live down there? You're all dying. The only thing that lives is the machine. It has robbed you of everything. And now you worship it.
I don't.
When it can work without you, it will let you die.
I was crying, Mother. I looked out of the mouth of the cave at a belt of mist lying between my hill and another hill. It was the color of pearl.
You're crying now? Go on.
I cannot.
Tell me the rest. You found your respirator, you made your way to the tunnels, and returned, and you reported your contact to the committee, didn't you?
By no means.
Well then?
The other woman comforted me.
He's angry, that's all. Angry that humanity has given up. But it hasn't, has it? You're proof of that. You came to the surface. You found us.
They made me food. It was simple, but it was the best food I've ever had. The woman who saved me came back. The man went to keep watch. It was night and the moonlight shone into the cave. The woman told me about Wessex as though it were a living thing.
Did you see the bones where you landed?
I think so.
They were from the Great Rebellion. The machine punished them with homelessness, but it killed them before they could find the means to live. A few crawled away and more have joined year by year. This is our home now.
But we are taught that the surface cannot support life.
You are taught lies.
They were honest, Mother. They were alive.
You look happy, Kuna. How can an experience so dreadful make you happy? You must be mad.
I suppose I must be. I wanted to stay with them. I wanted those hills and caves to be my home too.
But you came back. You reported to the committee. You did the right thing. The committee will understand. You're only young. I hope you reported those people.
You really don't understand, do you? There is no committee. We are going to die down here. The man was right. When the machine can work without us, it will let us all die.
You mustn't.
Blaspheme?
Go on.
It was night now. The man had been outside. Then he came back.
We have to go. Get out now.
What is it?
The mending apparatus. No, leave him. It can get him. That'll slow it down. We can run. We can get away.
No, don't leave me.
I am not leaving him behind. Get up. Right now! Don't mind the pain!
As we left the cave, I saw it.
The apparatus were worked by men?
No. They move by themselves. They are... like worms. Huge, white, disgusting worms, Mother. With teeth. Moving fast.
Oh, God!
She tried to help me. She slashed at it with her knife and it weakened its hold. I ran on, but when I looked back, it had her in its coils. Then a thing, like a great metal tongue, shot out and pierced her through the throat. I ran on until I reached the hole. I saw them slithering all over the grass, searching. They had come to repair the damage. I was the damage. I was able to climb down the ladder and make my way back. My leg was infected. Doesn't matter. I got home. I thought it was over, but the machine knew. It's going to punish me. That's why I had to see you before I go back to the surface.
Kuno, your appointment with the committee is in 10 minutes. Vashti, I have summoned a car which will take you to the airship.
I wish to stay.
That will not be possible.
Don't argue with it. I'll be all right. Go now.
Shall I see you again?
Goodbye, Mother.
Time passed. Humanity, quietly and complacently, was sinking into decadence. Things went from bad to worse. Food supplies dwindled. The apparatuses for reading, washing, and sleeping were increasingly faulty. Discontent grew as the end approached.
Have you tried the new food?
Is it another change to live in the
war?
Your attention. As of today, the use or possession of a respirator is illegal. Punishment is immediate homelessness.
Did you hear that?
I've not used the respirator in years.
Well, why would anyone wish to go to the surface? Crawling around in filth.
Oh, I've got one, but I never use it. I must destroy it.
Do the airships still fly?
No one uses them.
Your attention. Those wishing to study the surface may do so through archive material. Permits for study must be approved by the committee.
The machine feeds us.
The machine clothes us and houses us.
The machine allows us to communicate.
In it, we have our being.
Blessed be the machine.
Blessed be the machine.
Machine, there is something wrong with my music.
Do you wish to file a complaint?
Well, I cannot lecture without my music. Why can't you make it work?
Complaints are serious matters. Frivolous complaints are punishable. Do you wish to...
No, I'm sorry, no.
You have new messages.
What now?
Playing messages.
No. Stop messages!
Is something wrong, Vashti?
Vashti?
No, nothing is wrong. I feel a little unwell. I merely wish to isolate.
Sharp scratch.
Ow! No, that hurt!
Still.
No, I'm bleeding!
Procedures.
Stop! Medical procedures immediately!
You are unwell. Medical apparatus
activated. Keep still.
Proceeding with treatment.
Stop! Stop! Medical procedures immediately! I am perfectly well, thank you, machine. That concludes my lecture for today. Are there any questions? No one was listening.
You have an incoming screen call.
Mother?
Kuno. Where are you?
It doesn't matter.
Are you all right? It's been months.
More than that.
But you're alive. You know I can't visit you. They...
Mother, listen. The machine stops.
What did you say?
The machine is stopping. I know the science.
That means nothing to me.
You must have realized...
No, nothing is wrong. Why do you contact me with this blasphemy?
I see.
Play music. Stop it. Stop music now. I wish to make a complaint.
Your request is noted. The mending apparatus is very busy.
That's not good enough. Now! Should I? Why do I have to put up with this?
You have reached the mending apparatus.
Yes. My music...
What is the nature of your complaint? Is this an emergency?
Yes. I lecture in musicology. My music is essential to my work.
Music is entertainment merely. Your complaint is frivolous.
It most certainly is not. It is my work. This is making me ill, and I want it dealt with at once.
You are experiencing panic. Keep still.
Cancel! Complaint!
Complaint termination in process.
What shall I do?
Incoming conversation request.
Oh, Kuno, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that. Oh.
Vashti, do you have water?
I'm sorry, I thought you... I'm not sure.
Well, my water is just a trickle, and it smells. Something ought to be done. I complained to the committee, but nothing happened. The machine should admonish the committee.
I think they may be one and the same.
I must tell you this. My friend has applied for euthanasia. She says she has cancer. She says she is in terrible pain.
But that's not possible. No one has had cancer for...
I know. But you see, the machine wouldn't grant it. It wouldn't grant her euthanasia.
My son says the machine is breaking down.
Vashti, that is not only impossible, it is blasphemous. How we have advanced thanks to the machine.
Of course, how we have advanced. Machine.
You have registered 13 complaints with instance. 6 months. It is an offence.
Tell me the procedure for applying for euthanasia.
You are not eligible.
Why not?
Human death rate may not exceed birth rate. Workforce requirements for upkeep of machine.
I see. Produce my bed. I'm tired.
Bed in place. Dimming lights.
The bed is not there.
Bed in place. You will be informed when euthanasia becomes available.
No. Who is it? What do you want?
It's your neighbour. Open the door, please.
Why? I don't know you. What do you want?
Everything's wrong. The tunnels are filling with smoke. I'm frightened. Open the door. Let me in.
No, I can't.
Open the door, Jack.
No, go away. Go away.
You bitch, I'll kill you.
Go away.
No. Will somebody help me? What is it?
This is the mending apparatus. You logged a complaint.
I was asleep. Yes, I did. My music.
Personal complaints may no longer be dealt with by the committee.
Well, who then? Who shall I complain to?
That is unmechanical.
The food is rotting. The water stinks. I can hardly see.
Darkness and light are one.
Opening unheard message on.
No, I don't want
to. There's no more euthanasia.
There's the
secret. No,
to catch something terrible.
Why can't the machine help?
Someone has left them with the machines.
Tosh,
punish them.
Punish them with homelessness.
Finish the machine.
Kill some of them.
Kill them.
Avenge the machine.
In their thousands. Come to me.
Where?
Follow my voice.
Where are you?
Here's my hand. Mother.
Oh, my son. My son. Is there any hope?
None for us.
Hush now.
They wept for humanity. Those two, not for themselves. Their hearts were open.
Are we going to die?
Yes. Yes, but others live. On the surface. Maybe in the sky. Remember? I've seen them. It's tomorrow.
Some fool will start the machine again.
Never. We've learned.
The whole city was broken like a honeycomb. Airships crashed downward all over the earth, rending the galleries with their wings of steel. For a moment, mother and son saw the nations of the dead, and before they joined them, scraps of the untainted day.
In The Machine Stops by EM Forster. Bashti was played by Tamsin Gregg, Kuno by Tok Stephen, and The Machine by Veronica Roberts. All other parts were played by Sarah Laurie, Alana Ramsey, Wilf Scolding, and John Walk. The producer was David Morley. The Machine Stops by EM Forster was adapted and directed by Philip Frank.